to get the door.
Oh, are you good?
No, you got it. Door, dude, get the door! Get the door!
Trick or treat!
Those three kids remind you of something?
Oh shit! This come on every year. I used to love this.
What?
The movie starts out. It opens up on a neighborhood on Halloween night. Everyone's enjoying themselves, and the kids are all the same model as the main characters.
Yes. One thing to note is that the main character looks just like one of the first girls you see in the entire movie. But we get this little blonde boy. His name is Darren.
Darryl.
Why do I keep saying Darren?
So Daryl's running through the neighborhood like an asshole, trucking through kids, trying to get to his friend Kati, who is waiting for him at the cemetery, because I suppose they've marked that as a meeting ground so that they can head out on their night of trick-or-treating. All their friends are going to meet up here.
One thing to note about Darryl is that he has very nice Lego hair, and he definitely reminds me of a Lego person.
They all also have horribly disturbing little beady eyes and giant eye sockets.
Getting his little cousin, I think. His mom's making him... Sweet ride!
What are you supposed to be?
I'm a baseball player in his SUV. It's loaded with all the options, including anti-lock brakes and an atomic-powered laser cannon.
Atomic-powered laser cannons come standard on most Toyota 4Runners.
Oh, it's creepy out here.
Speak of the devil, and the devil shall appear!
Jimmy has apparently been there the entire time like an asshole, just waiting for somebody to say his name.
Looking back, that's pretty weird.
That's exactly what he was doing.
Yeah, he was just waiting for that event to trigger, so he's got that real NPC energy.
Hanging out behind that giant fallen over tombstone, just telling Hannah apparently to shut up and wait for somebody to say his name.
Just climb over everything, Hannah. I know you're like 5 years old, but just climb over everything.
Candy bars for trick or treat. I brought one for everyone. Oh.
Vaguely crunch bar.
Now is our time. We become monsters, surging forth and...
Monsters! Jimmy! I'm sorry, Jimmy. I didn't know how powerful it was.
Can you imagine if, like, Jimmy, he's on the floor, like, she goes to check up on him, and he's just seizing, like, very intensely?
Like, she triggered his epilepsy.
Yeah, like, Jimmy, I'm sorry, you forgot your pills!
Hello, Jimmy. Oh, don't you look cute?
Hannah, shine your flashlight around and scare all the monsters, okay? I need to talk to these guys for a second.
Okay, Jimmy.
Okay, here's the plan. We're gonna ditch Hannah. Well, if you're a big kid, you won't be afraid to trick-or-treat the Spook House!
Also, the house does not look abandoned whatsoever on the outside. It looks like it's pretty upkept.
Yeah, it looks pretty well, like, landscaped, and, I mean, there's some leaves in the yard, but
I'm pretty sure, if anything, they're just breaking and entering, and, like, just no one was home.
It looks fine.
Why are you crying?
Because I like the sound of booing. Boo-hoo!
Basically, Hannah is crying profusely, and that summons the scary godmother herself, Kathy Griffin, to come and try to console her. And scary godmother takes her to the spooky world, where she then goes to have a party with a bunch of monsters. Scary godmother is also doing this more so to actually warm her up to the fact that monsters are people too, essentially.
Take a deep breath.
If
I start scaring kids after hours, I'm gonna put in for overtime. Now calm down, kid, calm down!
Oh, help me, Lawson! Mean after all.
Well, to tell you the truth, monsters aren't mean. Big and scary, yeah, but not mean.
Big and scary is right.
Aw, you're just trying to butter me up.
Does that mean you'll stay?
You got it.
So now Hannah's met just about every monster that's gonna show up at this party, and she's starting to slowly realize, you know, they aren't that scary. Mm-hmm. They have scary things about them, but they're not that scary. And she's warming up to the idea that these are friendly little monsters, and she's going to have a good time. So while all this has been going on over at the Spooky Land, Jimmy and his friends have been waiting outside of the spook house for Hannah to come out scared so that they can continue with their trick-or-treating as Hannah runs home scared. But obviously she's having a good time, so the kids have basically wasted their entire Halloween waiting for Hannah.
Nobody is gonna win if we all do rock. Is that clear? Ready? Go! Ha! Rock beat scissors, scissors, scissors! I'm still the leader and I rule no more voting!
Meanwhile, at the Hall of Justice.
Oh, I just have to remind myself every now and again that it is the 20th century now.
21st century, my precious.
Great! Now my watch is stopped as well.
You're a vampire, but you have a sundial watch.
Extra cheese and olives! Yeah!
You eat pizza with cheese and olives?
Yeah, I like olives.
We're not so different, you and I.
12 pizzas, Harry?
Naturally, I wanted to be considerate of everyone's choices.
Why Harry that guy when you're ordering pizza, he the guy who say get wings?
You!
Where's Jimmy now?
Waiting for me, I guess.
Well, his wait is just about over. I think it's time we taught those big kids a lesson. Here's the plan.
Who the heck are you? What are you doing here?
I'm Orson. I am a vampire.
Oh yes, howl, howl, aren't I frightful? Rend, tear, fold, mutilate. Candy!
I'm here.
Who are you? What are you doing here, lady? What are you doing here?
I'm your scary godmother.
What are you doing with baby? Who's the baby? Tell me about that baby.
Look, I've been doing this for a long time. Couldn't find a sitter today. Had to make do.
Alright, fair enough. Whatever. You know, alright, I get it. You know what? That makes sense.
I'm here because one of you is afraid of something.
Yo, I ain't afraid of shit. Bitch.
You're afraid of your mom. And I can take care of that.
Will you?